Riverbond is an action-adventure game with couch co-op for up to 4 players set in a brightly colored voxel-based environment from an isometric view. You'll combat a variety of enemies and slash, smash, and shoot things into tiny little cubes. The developer kindly provided us a key, and the game was played on Windows PC. Riverbond has a very cute style to it that felt, in a way, like the old-school pixel graphic games that maybe just jumped off the page into a 3D world. Everything from the costumes you unlock, the creatures you combat, and especially the environments you play through are very vibrant. You'll take on different missions from the title screen. At the time of writing this, there are 9 total missions, each with its own different environment, and there are a variety of enemies to face off against. Each mission is broken into smaller pieces, requiring you to complete certain tasks before unlocking a gate which allows you into the next section. I found each entire mission can be played through in less than an hour, though I did spend extra time exploring each of the levels, so you might complete them much faster than I did. You'll encounter NPCs along the way who share bits of info. You'll also find chests and gift wrap packages containing new character skins, weapons, or other helpful items. I was even able to play as a piece of bacon. Score there. You change out weapons on the fly between the 5 different slots that you have available to use, but the character skins that you gain access to are only available at the start of each new map. Speaking of maps, the levels you play through are fairly compact, but I found myself wishing from time to time that there was some kind of mini-map, but there isn't anything like that in the game. Now be careful swinging and shooting your weapons around though, because many of the items placed around the levels are destructible. Who am I kidding? Shearing through piles of crates or a field of grass is actually rather fun, and it's neat watching all that stuff pop into a bunch of little mini-blocks and then disappear. Another cool feature is many of those things that you can destroy can also be picked up and hurled at your enemies to damage them. The game starts out fairly easy, as with many others, and then slowly ramps up the difficulty of the enemies and the number of them that you encounter. There are checkpoints in several of the levels that you play. When you eventually get slaughtered by a horde of creatures, you won't have too far to go so long as you've activated the checkpoint. You will always be able to return to the last one you activated, and you're free to reactivate the ones you've visited before. Combat was fun when facing off against solo or small groups of enemies, but at times you might find yourself swarmed. When that happens, prepare to die a couple times just to clear out the crowd, unless you can get a few of them to peel off towards you. Since you just respawn and there's no apparent penalty for death, the overall difficulty is pretty low, even for kids or players like me who can just kamikaze their way through to clear out an area. You can swing melee weapons, shoot ranged ones, and perform a leaping stomp attack to dish out the hurt. I found trying to shoot the enemies was often too frustrating to aim when using a controller, but worked better with mouse and keyboard. But I also found that it was more fun to play with a controller than on keyboard and mouse, so I didn't end up using ranged weapons all that much. For defense, you can roll dodge to try and avoid the punishment dealt your way, though the timing for some of the mini-bosses may require some practice. Luckily, with all the enemies you're going to face off against, you'll get plenty. One thing I'm not certain I cared for was how the tethering mechanic worked between the multiple players. When you play together and one of the players gets too far away, it teleports them back together. I wasn't able to discern the pattern as to how it makes the determination for who gets teleported. Sometimes it was the other player and sometimes it was me. I think I'd have preferred it stuck with the old mechanic where the screen slowly expands to a certain point and then you just can't move any further until you close the distance. But this way does, however, alleviate an issue where players might want to explore different directions and don't want to come back. Thus, it forces everyone to follow along with whichever player the game has chosen, but it can be slightly disorienting at times. Boss battles are much the same, but with a much bigger creature to battle in addition to the mobs that spawn around it, and it has a much, much beefier health bar. Once defeated, they pop out of existence, much like the destructible items scattered throughout each level, in a massive cloud of mini-blocks, which then dissipates. After all the running, slashing, and dodging, it's rather satisfying. So for my final thoughts on Riverbond, as to the rating, we break down our ratings into 5 categories, rate the game on a 1 to 10 scale with 5 serving as an average, and then average the overall scores into a final overall rating. For design, I gave this game a 9. The game has a great visual aesthetic, which very much lives up to what it was advertised as. The background music is very Minecraft-esque, and as are much of the action sounds, but it fits right in with the visuals. Challenge, I gave it a 3. There's not really a lot of challenge to the game, especially since the enemies keep the damage you've already dished out to them whenever you die. You can just keep rushing back at them till you've whittled them down. So the only real challenge is to see how long you can stay alive each time. For fun, I gave it an 8. Riverbond is a cute game. It's fun to play solo or with friends, and the minor frustrations I had with aiming didn't really detract too much from the overall experience. For longevity or replay, I gave it a 5. Personally, I don't see much of a reason to jump back into the game once all the levels are completed, unless you wanted to do it again with friends, but your mileage on that will vary, in part on how much you enjoy playing the game. For price, I gave it a 9. At $24.99 and with the ability for couch co-op or remote play on Steam, Riverbond seems like a pretty good deal to me. So that brings our overall score to a 6.8. I can certainly recommend this game, especially for younger generations. If you'd like more information on Riverbond, check out the links below for each of the storefronts it's on sale at. And for other game reviews, previews, and of course our weekly podcast, be sure to check out our website, www.bammsters.com.